Something's gonna happen right in this 3 minutes, like, for sure something's about to happen. Also, why is, oh god, it looked like her eyes were open. Why is he trying, so his beach is connected to all others, but he said the beach is just a place where people pass through to get to their afterlife, and everybody has their own beach. What if his wife and child already passed through, like, to the afterlife? Because I guess when everybody dies, they get stuck on the beach, right? And that's when they come back as a BT in our world. But what if somebody, like, already cut their umbilical cords? Or maybe I'm the only one that can do that and, like, send them back or send them on their merry way to the afterlife. I don't know. What if his daughter is one of the ones that I cut? Very confused. Yeah, right? Like, this is a weird... It's a very weird thing to do. Like, why am I just chilling here waiting? I'm just getting a ton of likes from Hartman just by zooming in on things.
Visit 218,550. Oh, sorry. Where were we? I may be used to the 21-minute cycle, but for a first-time face-to-face meeting, there's just too much to cover in one go-around.
Can't be easy living like this.
Yes. And no. Now that I'm acclimated to it, it isn't especially, onerous. Defecation, pollution, nutrition. Most of life's basic functions fit rather easily into a 21-minute time slot. Sleep is the tricky one. And intercourse, I suppose. Verbal or physical. Not that someone in my position has to worry much about either. Do you read, Sam? Listen to music. Watch films? You know, I keep busy. I have a collection of music, television shows, some very interesting short films, and stories. Everything consumable within a 21-minute window. All from before the Death Stranding, of course. But honestly, the 21 minutes I spend here, all downtime, nothing more. Time spent waiting to go back to the search. My body may be present, but my soul is on the beach. I'm already dead.
I know that feeling. Lost my family in an accident.
Well, I never expected you to open up to me. As it happens, I've read about your circumstances. I lost my family in an accident, too. I was in the ICU having heart surgery. Out of town, in the city. When it was clear that I was going to pull through, my wife took my daughter back to the house to collect some things for me. And then they were caught in the void outs. The city and the hospital were spared the worst, but the shockwave knocked out the power and my life support. I woke up on the beach.
Holy shit. That dude in a scuba suit?
The people who died in the two void outs were there. What happened? What's going on? I saw my wife and my daughter in the procession. Hey! It's me! Where are you going? Wait! Don't leave without me! No! Don't go! Please! Don't go!
Zeno, what are you doing?
The ICU's backup generator kicked in, and I was brought back to life by the defibrillator. Exactly 21 minutes after my heart had stopped. And that was the last time I saw my family.
You'd think he'd have some type of brain.
It's my damned heart's fault that we were torn apart.
Damage.
But it's also the reason I'll see them again someday. It defines me. I am Hartman. Ever since, I've walked the beaches of others. I follow my family's footsteps for a while, and when I get tired, I return here to continue my research. It's funny though, even when my heart stops, the pain lingers. You have any family photographs, Sam? Pity.
5 minutes to cardiac arrest.
You mind telling me what I'm doing here before you go back to the beach?
Oh, of course. There's a prepperone station in this area. Our scientists stationed there are researching material from before the Death Stranding.
What kind of material?
The Earth has a long memory. It's strata to tell a story, one that goes back to the very beginning, one that not even the Death Stranding could erase. The scientists are all colleagues of mine from the earlier expedition. I'd like you to bring them onto the chiral network. Amelie proposed we establish our research posts along this belt. Despite a worldwide search, this is the only area known to contain fossils from the late Cretaceous period. When the dinosaurs died out. The assumption being that the last ones lived here and here alone. You see, hiding in the earth then are memories of a major mass extinction. Clues that could tell us how to survive our predicament. Certainly, that was Amelie's hope as part of the advanced team when she assigned our backup team here. The past informs the present and aids us in building the future. She was careful to impress that upon us before she went west.
3 minutes to cardiac arrest.
Shut up. I'm putting you on mute. Sometime later, we began to observe unusual activity in the tar belts outside Edgenot City. vast quantities of tar began surfacing, spreading, consuming many of my colleagues, as well as a chiral way station. The whole incident defied explanation.
You think Higgs is to blame?
I don't know, but we needed that way station. It was essential to expanding the chiral network westward. That's why I'm asking you for your help in building a new one. It won't be much given the handful of equipment we've managed to scrape together. Nothing like the Knot Cities, that's for sure. But a knot is still a knot. Sam, I want you to use the Cupid to put the scientists on the network, then go to Armory. Afterwards, we can get back to the important job of researching the deaths.
And that's why the floors are made out of cushioning. I was very curious about that.
The air mentor absorbs the impact. I'll unlock the door for you.
Sam, you heard him. You can grab the order at a delivery terminal. Our ultimate objective in this region is to build a replacement for a way station that was lost to the Tar. The first step is to put a shelter with our scientists on the chiral network. Now, we don't know the first thing about Emily's status or what Higgs is up to. Now, that's a concern for us as much as you. But we won't know more until we get to Edge Knot City. And that means connecting this region first. You should start with the geologist and the paleontologist. The latter's holding something for the Evo-Devil biologist, so I recommend you save her for last. That way, you can finish a delivery and link up the final site in one go. Once all three are on the grid, come back here. Then we can get to work on the replacement for that lost way station. Geologist of ours has been studying fossils as part of his research into prehistoric extinction events. He's been out there conducting excavations for a while now and has begun to suffer the effects of chiral contamination. No doubt the result of excessive exposure to chirellium during the dig. Until the site is properly decontaminated, his work can't proceed. Nor will his health improve. So we need you to bring him some chirellium scrubbing agents.
Stratum the team was investigating dates from the end of the Cretaceous period, the time of the infamous mass extinction, which brought the reign of the dinosaurs to a close, leaving small mammals to inherit the Earth. It's the most recent of the Big Five, and one of the largest mass extinctions the world has ever seen. In any event, our team found something truly remarkable. Can you guess what it was? A fossil beach. If that is indeed what it is, then he has made a tremendous discovery. Therefore, Sam, it is essential that you deliver those chirellium scrubbing agents as soon as possible.
One more thing, Sam. For this run, you'll be transporting an antimatter bomb. A Bridges paleontologist working on a dig says he needs it. Apparently, the fossils he wants to study are buried deep beneath Tar, and the only way he can get to them is by blowing it wide open. Now, hopefully I don't need to tell you to be extra careful when handling high-yield explosives, but in case I do, make sure you keep that container in one piece, no matter what.
Dude, I've been doing this for a while. Alright.
Thermal pad. Indispensable gear for cold weather operations. Especially useful when traversing snow-capped mountains. Sam, I'm sure you haven't forgotten, but you need to be extremely careful.
You're first.
Keep on keeping on.
Ooh, it already happened.
Sam, so, Hartman told you all about the lake. How the attack that created it changed his life forever. Not only did he lose his family, he very nearly lost himself. For 21 minutes, he was in a state of cardiopulmonary arrest. Under normal circumstances, he would have died. Therapeutic hypothermia saved his life. But the 21 minutes he spent on the other side had a lasting effect on him. Perhaps due to the shock, his Doom's abilities seem to have increased. And now he takes every opportunity to walk the beach in search of his family.
My apologies, Sam. You came all this way to visit me, yet I neglected to give you a proper farewell. Do be careful out there. As I mentioned before, this region is rich in memories of death. Extinction. It should come as no surprise that VTs are sighted here more frequently. Perhaps you recall the models in my lab. Their designs were all based on eyewitness accounts. Though I suppose they must have struck you as strange, considering the many times you've come face to face with the real McCoy.
Well, it looks like I don't have any anti-VT guns to take care of this. I am 100% gonna have to do this on my own. Creeping about, you and me, little buddy. I wholeheartedly agree.
Damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it. Okay, I didn't even do anything. I'm literally standing still. Holy shit. This bomb. Brought two PCCs, unfortunately. Much not enjoying the whiteout conditions.
Oh, thank God for that.
It was like you straight out of Star Trek.